y'all, NayNay back with another video or whatever. And in today's video, I will be reviewing the hair paint wax. Now, if you don't know what hair paint wax is, it's a company on Instagram that you can use these temporary hair dye colors in your hair. So I will make sure I will link their website down below so you can go check them out. They have pretty affordable prices. And yeah, these are just all over Instagram. I've seen YouTubers use them. I used a orange color before. I just didn't show it on video. But this time I'm going to show me using these two colors, which I will get into in a minute. But if you haven't, please make sure you subscribe, become part of the Nay Gang, which is, you know, my channel, you know, and become a sub love, so be a bunch of old and so be OG. I would love to have you all. Please comment down below what you all think of this video. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up and smash that like button. And yeah, let's get right into it. For this particular style, I am parting my hair, the front and the back part of my hair, because since I am putting gel on those two parts, I don't want to do those and then put the gel on there, because the paint will transfer and get over your brush and whatnot even more, and it's just going to make it easier and cleaner process for when I do start putting my hair up in the bun. So you all will see that in a little bit. Alright, so now that my hair is clipped up, I am going to start from the back. The direction says apply a small amount to moderate amount of wax to damp hair, then style as usual. So it does say damp hair. You don't want to do this on soaking wet hair, because damp hair will actually make the color pop out a lot more than your average color. I think that's what I'm trying to say. So I want to make sure I get all my product in. Okay. I want to make sure I get all my product in my hair. This is what the red is looking like. And this is first time open. This is the white. And this is what the white is looking like, so. You're gonna get that candy cane effect either way. So, take some of that. I don't know if you can see it though.
So I just wanted to tell you all a little bit about this hair paint wax. So when the hair paint wax, it may look chalky, which it's not really chalky. It's very, very creamy. It's a very creamy consistency. So that is one thing, and it did not dry out my hair actually. Like, my hair still feels very moisturized, but that's because I did moisturize my hair before this process. Definitely do your style before you put the hair paint wax on. But the only reason why I'm styling as it is because it is their buns, their little puff balls. They're not like a wash and go. Like, definitely, if you're going to try this for a wash and go, definitely do your wash and go. Use all your products for the wash and go, and then put the hair paint wax on when your hair is still damp. However your hair is damp, is damp. But I didn't think that you all could see the color. The color actually turned out in this lighting. I didn't think it would, but it came out a nice red, and that's all that really matters, is that the red and the white were actually showing. And you'll see in the clip how my hair actually looks with both of them in my hair. But definitely follow me on Instagram, because I did put up a picture of how the hair paint wax looked in my hair, and I still have it in my hair now. It's probably going to stay in my hair till like the end of the Christmas week. But yeah, so, and it smells like men's cologne, which I really like. Like, I love having my hair smell like men's cologne. It smelled really, really good. And in the next part of the voiceover, I will tell you how I applied it to the rest of my hair. Because I started applying it one way in the beginning, but the other way was a lot more efficient. But I'll explain that in the next part of the voiceover.
Give a more vibrant color. But I like it so far. I like it a lot. I like it a lot. I don't know if y'all can tell, but it's my bad for the lighting. But yeah. But there is like white and red up in here. I don't know. Trying to see if that makes a difference or not. But yeah, this is what it's looking like so far. So let me continue.
So when I was doing the second side of my hair, the other bun, puff, whatever you want to call it, I noticed that it's easier to apply the paint not by rubbing it in between your hands like I first did, but actually just like putting the wax like on top of the hair and then raking it in that way. And just keep on applying some at the top and then just keep on raking it through, because I don't know, like when I was rubbing it through my hands, I felt like I didn't get all the color. This way I felt like I actually got more color in my hair and that the color popped more doing it that way. So I think there was a clip of me slowing it down to show you how I was doing it, but yeah, I stopped rubbing it in my hands. And I just kept on applying it just on top. And then I wet my hair as well. And if you can tell, before I apply the wax, I'm putting on products. So the products that I used were the Tuliwaji Curly Curl Cream. Yeah, and that's what my hair is looking like so far, with the red and the white. But yeah, so I use the curly cream. I use the Kinky Curly curling custard on the front and back part, the front and the back part of my hair, because that's how my hair really slicks down. But on the other side, on the other parts, I use the Joy My Gel to apply that through all the other sections between the top and the bottom. So I just kept on applying it, and you might be able to tell here that, yeah, so you see the wax, I'm just literally just putting it on top of my hair. I'm not rubbing it in my hands. I'm putting it on top, and then I'm going to start working the product through and raking it through my hair. So that's what I'm doing. And next, I believe, is me putting it up in a bun. The next clip. But yeah, like, as you can see, I'm just putting it on top. I'm not putting it in between my hands. I'm putting it on top, because that really, like, makes for the color to pop. And when you apply water, don't apply a lot of water, because the color will drip out. So when you're putting it up, like if you're putting it up in a bun or any type of style where you have to put your hair up, please be careful, because all that work you put in, you don't want to be lost. So this is just me putting up in a bun. I had to readjust my bun about maybe 2 or 3 times just to line it up and whatnot and get it adjusted. But I got it. So yeah, those are the buns all completed. I just had to pluck it out and whatnot, but you will hear more in the next clip. So enjoy.
Alright, y'all. So this is what it is looking like. On this side, I'll probably have to definitely put more color, because since one ponytail is always easier to do than the other. So this one I had to line up, didn't want to line up, and then I had to pull apart my hair because this side didn't look as full as this side. So so I will have to add more color, because it just looks like it's blended in. But I mean, I'm gonna have to add more color anyway tomorrow, because that's what this hairstyle is for, is tomorrow. So I'll probably just add like a little bit of water to activate the curls, not a lot, because this rinses out very easily with water. But so I'm probably going to put more color in here, and then I'm definitely going to put color on the outside, but I'm not going to do it tonight, because I am going to just let this dry overnight. So once this is dry and this sets, like the gel needs to set too, like I can tell it's setting on this side, but the gel needs to set on this side as well. In terms of the hair paint and how much I used, this is how much of the white that I used, and this is how much of the red that I used. Well, there was some missing in here before, so yeah, but this is what it's looking like. Which, I mean, I could probably get a few uses out of it. I have a lot of hair too, so like, if you have a lot of hair like me, then I don't know how many uses you can actually get out of it. But as you could see, like in the video, like it was really clumping my curls and was weighing my curls down, which I now know what that means. It feels like, because that's exactly what it's doing. I like that. So yeah, but this is the final result. Would I recommend this product? Of course. Like, this is temporary hair dye. You can do whatever colors you want and mix colors and do whatever, you know, make your own colors. I think that is dope. Yeah, like this is what it's looking like. So I'm very excited. I can't wait to see how this dries. And if I have time tomorrow before the holiday party I'm going to, I will record myself touching up the color, just to see how it's done, because you want to apply this when your hair is wet. On dry hair, like your hair looks like very straight, so you run the risk of letting the color go out, but you're going to add more anyway, so you definitely use water. But yes, those are my final thoughts. So thank you all for watching this video. If you haven't, please subscribe, follow my social media, where you see exclusive content. And am I forgetting something? Oh yeah, make sure you give me a big old thumbs up and smash the like button because it definitely helps me out. And I will see you all in the next video. Love you guys. Bye.